姐妹平安，今天是六月初五，六月份头一个主日，跟各位奉主的圣名，大家来聚集。弟兄姊妹，咱知啊，现在教会除了有这个叫做 online 的 worship， 咱已经开始 onsite in person 的 service。但是对于六月份开始，咱除了九点半到十点半，咱有一个叫做 bilingual service 以外，咱六月咱除了温春，咱要开始叫做大家来个 worship。上时九点半到十点半，所以因为咱就开始 Sunday School 的 ministry， 所以今仔来检查你出来的工人，还是你的瓦车、你的车头，还是你的朋友，爱来大家来个 worship 的人 ，You're welcome to join with us。九点半到十点半，第二卡 MB 初有一个大家来 worship。所以用两个聚会，大家来敬拜咱的上帝。咱将大家聚会搞到聚会手中，咱大家来祈祷哈。感谢上帝来到六月份头一个主日，主来帮助你的教会。虽然疫情千秋慢慢已经较好些，阮献出阮的感谢。我讲大家人有通辛苦继续勇敢，我讲慢慢大家来 back to normal， 大家恢复正常，阮的生活、阮的聚会都很好些。阮为着六月份阮有开始大家来个 worship， 或者来帮助阮。除了有这个 bilingual worship， 阮有这个大家来 worship， 我阮伫无上迄个级别无上个缘故的顶面，大家来敬拜属奉阮的上帝。讲各种物种杂起的聚会，交到主的手中，求主的圣灵来带领阮敬拜的时间。现在阮来感谢甲阮的基督，奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名 ，Amen and Amen。你这边大家用 music 来音乐来安慰咱的上帝。
Strong man boast in his strength. Let not the rich man boast in his riches, but let the humble come and give thanks to the one who made us, the one who saved us. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who's worthy. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who's worthy. He's worthy. Let not the wise man boast in his wisdom, or the strong man boast in his strength. Let not the rich man boast in his riches, but let the humble come and give thanks to the one who made us, the one who saved us. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who's worthy. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who's worthy. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who's worthy. I will boast in the Lord my God.In Christ alone, I will make my boast in Christ alone. I will make my boast in Christ alone, alone. I will make my boast in Christ alone. Yeah, I will make my boast in Christ alone.Yeah, I will make my boast in Christ alone. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who's worthy. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who's worthy. I will boast in the Lord my God. the one who is worthy. I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who is worthy.
I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one
who is worthy.
I will boast in the Lord my God. I will boast in the one who is worthy.
He's worthy. Is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, His gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones He came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on Him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. Here in the power of Christ, I stand.
你准备平安，咱是个人呢，陪伴咱的心灵，耶稣主的饼及主的杯，且得按圣经话。在哥林多前书第十一章13-18节，圣经讲：我当日传道恁的，原是对主所领受，所以主耶稣并非一暗托起饼来，祝谢了就劈开讲：这是我的身躯，为你放杀，你就按呢行，为的是纪念我。饭后也同款托起杯来讲：这个杯是用我血所立的新约，你特别啉的时就按呢行，为的是纪念我。你特别食这个饼、啉这个杯，是表明主的死直等到伊来。所以无论什么人，若无按你食主的饼、啉主的杯，就是干犯主的心及主的血咯。所以人应该家己省察，然后食这个饼、啉这个杯。这段圣经是保罗写给教会，教导咱照着耶稣主的饼及主的杯。主要说，并非一暗将这个圣餐来设立。伊将这个饼劈开，将伊葡萄汁倒出。主耶稣讲，这个饼是代表我的身躯，这个葡萄汁是代表我的血。这个饼劈开，这个葡萄汁倒出，是代表主耶稣的十字架为咱的罪，将身躯劈开，将宝血流出来洗净咱的罪。但系圣经及人讲，人应当家己省察，然后食这个饼，啉这个杯。所以你做圣餐的人，需要家己好来祈祷，好来省察家己，避免这个心来耶稣做咱的饼及主的杯。咱时刻安静地坐位里面，好来祈祷，求上帝灵来省察咱，避免咱的心来耶稣主今日好咱的饼及主的杯。咱大家来唱一个圣诗，比如咱的心灵耶稣做个饼及做个杯，咱唱咱的圣餐的歌，省察家己。咱大家来唱。
当我们走到神的面前，默默审查自己，回想以往的年日里，蒙了多少恩典。主啊，主啊，我亏欠了你，我真亏欠了你。求主赦免我罪过，怜悯我们。有多少时间奉献给你，专为子子而求？再多少思想亏欠了主，养生的担忧。主啊，主啊，我亏欠了你，我真亏欠了你。求主赦免我罪过，怜悯我们。如今我愿意悔改谦卑，求主进入我心中，愿将一生 身给主，全给主使用。主啊，主啊，我感谢你，我也感谢你，因为你已赦免我们，拯救我们。
那这个人也是主的饼和主的杯， put the bread and the cup together。我们再做一个感恩的祈祷。天父，我们感谢你，你听我们，将你独生子主耶稣赐给我们，为我们的罪钉在十字架里面，将你的身躯劈开，主将宝血流出，来洗净我们的罪，医治我们一切的亏欠，让我们在做上帝你的儿女。今天有通领受你的饼入你的杯，让你的生命提醒我们已经在我们的里面。保罗说，现在活着不再是我，乃是基督在我里面活着，让我们因为主的生命的原因，让我们一生为主来活。弟兄们，感谢你，祝福今天在你的头前领受饼和杯的姊妹，愿我们每一个人，我们的身躯，我的灵，我的魂，拢都蒙主你家己的保守，完全无通指跌，直到主耶稣第二摆对天顶过来。愿上帝祝福你，赐恩给你，祈祷奉告主耶稣基督的圣名， Amen。 愿上帝祝福你，兄弟姊妹， Amen。
兄弟姊妹平安。
Peace be to you, dear brothers and sisters.
能够思想神的公义，伟大的神奇妙救恩这个系列的信息。
Let's continue in our series, God's Righteousness, a Great God, Amazing Salvation.
今日思想信徒有什么可夸呢
？And our topic for today is what can believers boast in?
经文是罗马书第五章一到第十一节。
And our scripture can be found in Romans chapter 5, verses 1 to 11.
那罗马书第一到第四就是讲因信称义的真理。
Romans chapters 1 to 4 talks about justification by faith.
第五章第一节。
In chapter 5, verse 1,
保罗讲，所以咱既然因信称义。
Therefore, since we have been justified through faith.
那保罗意思是讲，咱若接受了第一到第四就因信称义的真理。
If we have accepted, Paul was saying, if we have accepted the truth that can be found in chapters 1 to 4,
咱已经因信称义了。
Then therefore we are justified through our faith.
但是你若对另外一个角度来看这项代志。
But if you are to look at it from another point of view,
因信称义的真理，让人知影人的失败。
And this, this truth about justification through faith talks about our human failure.
因为在称义的代志顶面，
especially when it comes to being justified,
人是完全无通创任何的代志。
There's nothing that we can do to be justified.
所以罗马书第三章保罗应证明世界人都是罪人。
That's why in chapter 3 of Rome, the book of Romans, Paul had already proven how we are all sinners.
无人有通靠这个立功的办法，就是靠好行为，伊的德行来得救。
Nobody can save themselves through their own behavior.
就这个办法，
There's only one way.
就是信主的办法。
That's the way, the only way through salvation is for them to have faith in Christ.
所以罗马书第五章开始到第八章。
That's why in Romans chapter 5 to chapter 8,
保罗是用正面的角度来解释因信称义的真理。
Paul is showing us this positive view.
啊，是安尼讲。
Let's look at it. Let's say it in this way.
当咱因信称义以后
，After we have been justified through faith,
咱得到了什么
？What have we achieved？
咱有通夸口什么
？What can we boast in？
你看，都给夸第五章第一节。
Let's continue continue on in chapter 5, verse
1.
Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. This is one of the most important verses in this whole chapter. Because from verses 2-11, all the verses there are based on this verse 1. How we have been at peace with the Lord already.
So
that's why in English the word there is we have peace. Peace is very precious. This English name Irene.
Pastor Dr. Irene.
Of course we have our own pastor Dr. Irene.
Irene is
the name Irene means peace. Peace is very precious. But the Chinese meaning for the word peace, a definition for the word peace is different from what's in the Bible. For the Chinese people, peace is when nothing untoward is happening. I thank God I did not contract COVID. There's peace. I've not been in any accident. There's peace. But in the biblical perspective, peace means being in perfect fellowship or in a perfect relationship. In the Jewish term, it's called shalom. We have a good relationship with God. We are at peace with God. How we as sinners have this good relationship with the Lord. We are at peace. What's the biggest problem that we are facing in this world? It's not a problem of energy. It's not a shortage of food. It's not a matter of war. The biggest problem in the world is relational crisis. Because all the other problems that we are facing has its root here. And the biggest problem, the biggest crisis that we are facing in this world today is we have a problem in our relationship with the Lord. But we thank God that after we have been justified through faith, our relationship with the Lord has been restored. We are at peace with Him. From verses 2-11, there are three areas that we can boast in. What can we boast in? Boast in the hope of the glory of God. Boast in God's grace in the midst of our sufferings. And boast in God as our delight. Let's look at these three points one by one.
Number one.
First is we can boast in the hope of the glory of God. In verse
2.
Through him we have also obtained access by faith into this grace in which we stand and we rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. The word here that's being used is the word rejoice. But in the original text, it means to boast. This is the first area we as believers can boast in. We boast in the hope of our glory in the Lord. In reality, as a church, we have nothing to boast in. Because everything that we have is a blessing from the Lord. If you want to boast in one thing, the hope that we have in the glory of God. We find it strange to boast in the glory. Because we cannot boast in the hope, rather. Most of us boast in the things that we have already achieved, things that we have.
For example,
5 years ago, we planned to build this discipleship center. And we know the enormous amount of need that we have. And during that time, we have nothing to boast upon. Because we have no idea whether we will succeed in this endeavor or not. Now that we have already completed our discipleship center, maybe some of us will boast in our discipleship center. You've seen how big and how beautiful it is. I'm saying this not for you to boast in it. Because in truth, we have nothing to boast about. Everything is God's blessing. But the world boasts in things that they already achieve or things that they already have. Boasting is rooted in our pride. If I have not achieved yet, then what can I boast in? For example, if I boast here in the future, I will be the wealthiest person in the world. I'll be the most educated person in the world. After I've said this, nobody can clap their hands for me. Because it has yet to happen. It's something that you just said for yourself. But in case I truly become one of the wealthiest or the wealthiest person in this world, or I've become the most educated person in the whole world, maybe then people will applaud me because I already achieved it. But Paul said we boast in the hope of the glory of God. What Paul is saying, we don't boast in ourselves, but we boast in God. We boast in God's faithfulness. Because what God has promised will happen. After we become Christians, we have received so many promises from the Lord.
New heaven and new earth.
The promise of a new heaven and new earth.
Jerusalem.
A new Jerusalem. The fruit of our life, that we have this living waters that's in us. We have this glorified body. These are things we will attain in the future. Because God is faithful. Look at 2 Corinthians 1 verse 20. For no matter how many promises God has made, they are yes in Christ, and so through Him, the Amen is spoken by us to the glory of God. No matter how many God's promises may be,
yes in Christ.
Because they are all yes in Christ. This is the thing that we boast in, the hope of the glory. We boast in God's faithfulness. The second thing, we boast in God's grace in the midst of our sufferings. Look at verses 3 to 5. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that sufferings produces perseverance, and perseverance character, and character hope. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. Look at verse 3. More than that, we rejoice in our sufferings. Again, the word here being used is rejoice, but in the original text, it is to boast. This is the second thing that we as Christians or believers can boast in. In the midst of our sufferings, we boast in the grace of our Lord. And again, this is different from the way the world thinks.
Because
when this world boasts, they boast in successful things.
When
they boast, they boast in things that are very smooth. Nobody will boast in their failures. Nor will they boast in their sufferings. But we are not demented people. Why do we boast? Because in the midst of our sufferings, we have experienced God's grace. Because in the midst of our sufferings, when we experience God's grace, we give glory to God. And this is truly the reason why we boast. Please take note. Suffering is not the ultimate purpose of our lives, but suffering is only the means to an end. For us, God allows sufferings to come into our life because He wants us to attain this very important goal.
什么目的呢?
And what is this purpose?
他说,一直患难中间都是吞论,吞论中间就是老练,老练中间是就了盼望。
Suffering produces perseverance, perseverance produces character, and character produces hope.
来来慢慢解释这三个字,
Let's explain this.
他说,头这样的字,
the first,
因为患难的时候,
because suffering produces perseverance.
你知道,吞论哦,是关真正的了不起的力量的来面。
You know, to persevere is something that's inexplicable. The strength that we find is inexplicable.
因为吞论让人承受,普通人没能承受的等大。
Because when we persevere, we can attain things which no ordinary people can attain. We can endure much more sufferings than other people can endure. You know this word in Chinese character, persevere, perseverance, is very meaningful. It's a two-edged blade that's piercing in your heart. So anytime you make a move, it's very painful. In English,
perseverance.
This word
perseverance,
it means to stand firm underneath great pressure. You know, in English, there's a phrase that's easily explained, that can explain this.
Staying power.
It's called staying power. Staying power. So in the midst of our sufferings, we have a chance to exercise and to expand our staying power. Because without experiencing sufferings, there is no way for us to strengthen our staying power. Just like Daniel. He was prohibited to pray to any gods or anything for 30 days. But he stood firm. That's what we call staying power. Job has been attacked by Satan twice. But he stood firm. Because he let God be God. That's what we call staying power. Dear church, we live in a sinful and wicked world. And it's a very pitiful world. There's no way that anyone can avoid suffering in this world. Including we who are Christians. But God allows suffering to come into our life because He has one purpose. Because He wants us to be able to establish our staying power. Do you know? Elderly people would often not want to walk. But they need to continue walking. Because once they stop walking, they will slowly learn and not know how to walk. Because when you don't walk, because your brain would give you this message, you don't need to walk. But once you continue walking, maybe there's pressure that you will feel in your legs. Maybe you find it difficult.
但是这个时候,
but during that time,
你就训练你的 staying power 在你的脚里面,
that's when you practice and you exercise your staying power.
慢慢你就走起来了,
slowly you continue walking.
其实你的信心上上上的了,
but it's the same for our faith.
你面对困难的时候,
once we are facing difficulties,
你若不去面对,
if you refuse to face it,
你的 staying power 就不出来,
then your staying power will not be evident.
但是你记得,
but remember,
你已经是跟上帝和好的人啊,
we are we who are at peace with God.
你是咱天顶的老爸啊,
He's our Heavenly Father.
在患难中间,
the midst of our sufferings, He would help us to achieve that staying power. That's why suffering will produce perseverance. But that we're not finished yet. Because perseverance will produce character. In the original text, this word character is very unique. There are two meanings in it. NIV translated it into the word character.
Experience.
But we can translate it into the word experience. A person who has a staying power in the midst of their difficulties, they will gain experience in resolving things. But again, we can look at it as character. And most of the time, our character is a product of the things that we experience, the difficulties that we experience. If you have not gone through sufferings or difficulties, your character will not be evident. I would like to explain this based on my own experience. You know, as I've been shepherding the church for 30 plus years, the most difficult problems that I face is resolving problems between co-workers. When I say co-workers, I mean the pastoral team, our church leadership, and everybody who's involved in the church. And this is most often my biggest problem. I am a person who sleeps quite easily. When I lie on my bed, in about 5 minutes, I'll be gone. I'll be asleep. But when I'm facing problems between my coworkers, I would stay awake even until 2 or 3 in the morning. Especially when I hear people saying bad things behind my back. I'll be accused of being very arrogant or very domineering or unwilling to listen to the opinions of other people. And I feel very sad listening to it. During one time, I was speaking to a coworker in the church. I said, I cannot depart from CBCP right now. Because if I leave right now, the church will be in chaos. You know what happened next? After a few days, after a few years, this person was about to leave CBCP, he publicly said one thing. He said, Pastor Chung, Reverend Chung is a very arrogant person. He said, if he leaves CBCP, CBCP will be chaotic. He's very prideful. After I've heard it, I could not respond. Because I truly made that statement. But that was not the context of what I said. Because during that time, we were facing interpersonal problems in our church. Co-workers were about to leave. That's why I said, if I leave during that time, the church will be in more difficulties or chaos. But it was taken out of context and he spread it to have a different meaning. I could not respond.
但是啊,
but,
上帝是公义的啦,
but God is just.
And
after the few years, succeeding few years,
我跟你讲, 没这个人, 后面攻击我的人是成功的。
Nobody who would say things about me from my back or would succeed.
因为我在恨罪的中间，我对上帝存着个无亏欠的心来侍奉上帝。
Because in all these years when I serve the Lord, I will not serve the Lord lacking anything.
但是我要讲这样个事。
But I want to share one thing.
虽然遇到真罪，安尼款的攻击、款的患难、款的批评。
Even though I've been criticized and been persecuted a lot.
但是我这个人哦，实在较有经验。
I have more experience right now.
And
right now I've gained insights on how to resolve conflicts.
In
the midst of great pressure, we become more mature.
That's
why perseverance would produce a character or experience.
The
third,
是盼望
and our character will produce hope.
那这个盼望不是普通的盼望啊。
This kind of hope is not an ordinary kind of hope.
这个盼望是无见效的盼望。
This is a hope that's not ashamed, that's not embarrassed or ashamed.
你看第五章第五节。
Look at verse 5.
伊讲盼望无止见效啊，因为咱所属咱的圣灵将上帝的浇灌在咱的心里面。
And hope does not put us to shame because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. Our problem right now is we ask ourselves, will hope produce shame? Just think about
this.
Will our hope bring us to shame?
Yes.
Yes.
Maybe
some of us would hope for things that are so high. But it's not
achievable.
So that's why it's shameful to say it. Let's say, for example,
and
through my experience, my foresight for this,When you buy this stock, you would experience great gain. But what happened next? People listen to you. And so they bought a lot of this, the shares. But the stock crashed. Then the stocks that they have became worthless. You are put to shame, that person is also put to shame. There are some hopes that will truly shame us. Because it's unachievable. But what does the Bible say? The hope that you have in this will not put you to shame.
什么原因呢?
Why?
是不是浪中所盼望的得个成就得个得着呢?
Is it because that everything we hope for we will attain?
No.
No.
基督徒,
As Christians,
我说难道上帝盼望难不得着?
Sometimes we hope in the Lord for certain things that we will not achieve or gain.Or sometimes when we pray, God doesn't seem to answer us positively in our prayer. Why is it that we do not lose hope?
Because
God's love is in our heart. What does this mean? Let me explain.
For example,
as parents, we have this hope for our children.
What
kind of hope? We want them to be healthy as they grow up.
That they'll
find a good partner, a spouse, that they'll have a family of their own in the future.
And
they will be able to establish their own family.
And
after we've seen it, we become so happy. Let me ask
you, is
it true that this kind of scenario would happen for all Christians?
No.
No.
There
are times that our children will grow up against the way we want them to grow up.
In fact,
there are children who will not even live past the age of
15.
Would be find shame in it.I believe in the Lord, I trusted in the Lord, but the Lord didn't seem to take care of my own children. When my child got sick, I prayed to the Lord, but the Lord didn't seem to listen. Would you lose hope in the Lord? Would you think that my hope in the Lord had put me to shame.
未信主的人说,
those who are non-Christian will say, you believe in the Lord, look, your child is dead. How do we face such a situation? Paul said, we will not be put to shame because the love of the Lord has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit.
这什么意思呢?
What does this mean?
比方说, for example,
for example, this child, the 15-year-old child truly died. We are not ashamed.
You know why?
You know why?
Because
in the past 15 years,
上帝听在我和我的孩子的生命中间。Because
God's love is in me and in the life of that child.
听是真正万代宝贵的怜悯。
Love is something that is very precious.
有听所在, 无坚守的所在, 有听所在, 无浪费, 无接托的所在。
When there is love, there is hope. When there is love, there is no waste.
那就感谢上帝,
let's thank God that I have this precious gift of love in my life for the past 15 years.
虽然可能较低淡薄,
maybe it's not a long period of time,
但是我没见笑,
but I do not find shame in it because there's love in it.
因为我知道,
because I know
将来我跟我的孩子,
one day I will be reunited forever with my child.
有听的人, 有听的所在,
when there is love, when people who have love, they will not be put to shame.
你看这个世界人,
look at this, the people of this world.
等于有听的时候,
when they have love,
哇, 两个人就一个人不见笑的,
they are not ashamed to be together with the person that they love.
有时候我们看到他在外面很亲哦, 难见笑与不见笑啊,
sometimes we find it embarrassing just to look at them showing affection to each other publicly.
因为有听,
but because they have love,
因为感到见笑,
they do not find shame in what they're doing.
上来呢,
the next one,
保罗第五章第六到第八节,
in chapter 5 verses 6 to 8, Paul said
讲了一段真特别的话,
here Paul says something very important.
什么话呢?
What did he say? You see, at just the right time when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though for a good person someone might possibly dare to die. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Here Paul is saying to us, do not doubt God's love. Because when we were still sinners, when we were without hope, God's love had already become evident in our lives. God gave his own son to die on the cross for us. Why then do we doubt God's love? That's why the hope that we have in the Lord is a hope that will never put us to shame. That's the second thing that we can boast in as believers. In the midst of our sufferings, we boast in the grace of our Lord.
And
the last one, we boast in God as our delight. Look at verses 9 to 11. Since we have been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through him? For if while we were God's enemies, we were reconciled to him through the death of his son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through his life? Not only is this so, but we also boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Look at verse
9.
Since we have now been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through him? There are two time frames here that's completely different. In English, it's very clear. What now is, and the word first is now, and the next is shall.
这个是现在, 这个是将来,
one is in the present, one will be in the future.
他说现在,
now we have been cleansed by the blood of Christ.
将来呢,
in the future.
내가 면기 상대 혼노 the wrath of God.
We are safe. We will be safe from God's wrath.
这个 혼노是什么 혼노啊?
What kind of wrath is this?
讲到将来末日的审判.
It's called the judgment in the end times.
咱将来面对上帝审判的时阵.
As we face God's judgment in the end time,
咱不会怕.
We will not be afraid.
为什么不会怕?
Why? Because we have already been justified by the blood of Christ and we are declared righteous. I don't know if you paid attention. From verses 10 to 11, three times of a word was mentioned. And how we have been reconciled. How we have been reconciled again and again with the Lord. So we have no fear. Look at verse 11. He added a phrase here. Not only that. Or more than that, we also rejoice in the Lord through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, through whom we have now received reconciliation.
Rejoiced in God.
And this is the third time this word rejoice or boast is mentioned here. And this is the third thing that we can boast in. What do we boast in? We boast in God. God becomes our joy. I don't know what things in your life or what situation in your life brings you joy. Probably 40 years ago, I was watching this commercial in Hong Kong. It's something that's very amusing. The person was opening a very small notebook. It's a green book. It's a green booklet. And when they opened it, and there were green lights that were shining from it. And I found it strange. Regardless of whether you're male or female, whether you're old or you're young, whenever they open that booklet, that green light would shine on them. Would look at her face. They'll start to smile. At first, they will not smiling. But the more they smile, the bigger their smile became. So I found it to be very interesting. You know what kind of a commercial it is? It's a commercial for a bank. It's encouraging people to open a dollar account. Because a dollar is green. So when you open an account, a dollar account in Hong Kong, they'll give you a green booklet. So when you open it,
a
green light will come out. So it's very clear, it means that your dollar savings is increasing. And everybody smiled. Because they found joy in their financial wealth. You know, as parents, you know, the first time I became parent, when I saw my child, when I picked up, I carried my child, I smiled naturally because I found joy in my child.
Chairman,
let me ask you, in your life, after you become Christians, do you find your delight in the Lord? The very famous theologian Augustine said, there's a vacuum in the heart of man which only God can satisfy. We know that Augustine, while he was young, lived a very hedonistic kind of life. And he repented. And he became a theologian.
Confession,
and he wrote this very famous book called Confession. The first thing he said, the first sentence in the book, you have made us for yourselves, O Lord, and our heart is restless until it rests in you. God is our God is the only one that can truly bring joy and satisfy our soul.
真出名的文学家，这个小巴拉讲了一句话。
A very famous playwright by the name of George Bernard Shaw said,
伊讲人生有两个悲哀啊。
There are two great tragedies in life.
第一
，The first,
爱得到的未得到
，Not getting what you desire.
第二咧
，The second.Getting what your heart desires but not finding satisfaction. Of course, if you have not achieved it, you will not be happy. But after getting it, you still do not find satisfaction. I'm not saying this to have a bad intention. There are people who like to get married. If I'm not married, I'm not happy. After you're married, not everybody becomes happy. And other people even regret getting married. Because being married is not the thing that will bring us satisfaction in life. Without God, it doesn't matter whether you're married or not, it will not give you true satisfaction. And lastly, I would like to give you this passage in the Bible. Psalm 37, verse 4.Take delight in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. You know, I have three children. And my love for all three of them are equal. I don't have favoritism. What I give to the one, I'll give to the two others. But among the three children, eldest child is the one who knows my heart. You know, while she was in grade school, I went to the school to fetch her. And I met with one of her teachers. And that teacher was, I'm quite familiar with that teacher. Because she's also a Christian. Pastor, you're here. And he said to me, you know, your daughter is so proud of you. I said, what did she say?Today, she said to her classmate, you know who my father is? My father is a pastor. Because in her mind, pastor, she thought that being pastor is something that's really big and great. Because she knows my heart and she finds joy in me. That's why whatever she desires, we give.
She
often tells other people that I'm her driver.
Because
whenever she needs to go out, she would ask me to drive and I would drive her. But this is something mutual. That's what it's written in the Bible. When you take your delight in the Lord, He will give you the desires of your heart. So may the Lord help us. Christians, after we've come to know the Lord, there's nothing that we can boast in. But if you truly want to boast in something, boast in the hope of God's glory. Boast in God's grace in suffering. Boast in God and delight in the Lord.
Chairman,
let me ask you,
你心内,
in your heart, what do you boast in?
上帝是不是你唯一应该夸口的所在呢?
Isn't God your only source of boasting?
这是因信称义, 那就positive side, 正面的反应了。
This is the positive response to being justified by faith.
叫主祝福人。
May the Lord bless us.
我们实在明白地球唔那是无未去阴间无去 hell， 咱无通以上帝在做咱生命中间的喜乐啦。
That salvation is not just merely being saved from eternity in hell， but the being able to find delight and being able to boast in the God。
愿上帝祝福。
May the Lord bless us。
那来祈祷。
Let's pray。
感谢上帝。
Thank you, Lord。 Not only are we justified by faith to be saved from death and to be saved from our sins, but because we are justified by faith, we can boast in the Lord. Lord, we thank you. We can boast in the hope of your glory. And in the midst of our sufferings, Lord, we boast in your grace. And we boast in you because you are our delight, Lord. Lord, when you truly become our only source of peace, satisfaction, and completeness, Lord, that we can truly enjoy this precious blessing, that we can understand how precious this gospel is. Thank you, Lord. Listen to our prayers. This is our prayer in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.